Hey guys, welcome to another exciting tutorial of creation process, and in this video we'll be making a unique style of professional logo. And this kind of logo I've never made before, so let's begin with the tutorial. First we will use the ellipse tool and make a circle and remove their strokes and fill it with color. Now make one more circle from inside and give some thickness to it. Now select both the rings and separate it. Now duplicate the object one more time by alt and click drag. While doing that, make sure you make sure you're doing this very carefully, because you have to see that they curves are overlapping each other. The points should be overlapped, because this is a very important part of portion of this tutorial, because if you don't do it, it will create some bigger problems later. So make sure that they are overlined in the same way. Now duplicate it one more time and keep it over it, and do the same thing. Zoom in and place it over it very carefully. After that, now drag and alt drag, duplicate it and align it using the align it properly. Now here, duplicate it one more time and place it here carefully and zoom in and just align it. This is a very important part. Every time you have to do it, you have to align it properly. Slide this portion a little bit closer and maintain their heights. Now we will take one more ring and duplicate it, alt and drag, give some this much portion or gap. Now alt and drag, duplicate it, give some gap from here, duplicate one more time, make sure they are overlapped and over each other. Okay, we'll make one more ring here and keep it here. Place it here carefully, same way, duplicate one more, place it here, duplicate one more and place it here. So once you have done that, just select both this ring and bring it closer. Make sure they are overlapping. So once you have done that, we'll select a whole of the object together. We'll use the shape builder tool. Here we select the shape builder tool. Now we will combine few shapes together. So with the shape builder tool, click and select and make the shape. Combine it until you got it right. Combine this and this too, and we'll separate this by clicking on this. Combine this one. Now we'll separate this and this, and we will combine this portion together, this one. So simply you have to make sure that you are doing it properly. We will combine with this portion and we will combine this portion together. So you have to do it to understand this push, this one, just making this curve, this one, and this portion. We'll use this, and this, and this one, and let's combine this. We need this separately. And see this combined. So we got this, we got this, we got this, we got this, we got this object. So everything we want is almost near. Separate this one, separate this portion, separate this portion, separate this portion, separate this portion. Okay, we'll work on this after a while. So after this we will click it outside and delete the portion which you don't need. So I don't need split it, I don't need this portion, I don't need this one, this one, I don't need this, 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 this one, and this one too. And rest we will edit it using the rectangle tool. I will make a rectangle here from the center and just make it here. Now we'll select both, subtract it, we'll make one more rectangle here, we'll make a rectangle now, and we need to separate this portion. So this one until here, so we'll make a rectangle here. I'll select all of them, all of them. Now we'll work with it again with the shape builder tool. I'll combine this, this, and this, and this portion. We'll combine this portion, and we'll combine this portion. So what I'll do that, we will deselect it and select all the unnecessary portion which you don't need. So delete all the stuff which you don't need. I need a smooth curve here. So I'll take one ring anywhere from here, or maybe this, and alt and drag, I place it carefully here so that I can get the outlines. We'll make a rectangle from the here and we'll give some height, this much, maybe this much. Select both of them, go to shape builder, and we will separate this, 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 separate this, this. You can delete this portion, whole portion of this, and we don't need this, so we will use one more rectangle from here. And we'll select a whole of the objects, and using the shape builder tool we will again do the same thing. Separate, 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 and just delete this portion which you don't need. So once you got that, you got this cool, this kind of design. We got this portion separate, we got this portion. We need to do one more thing. We select this one and combine it. This is one object. We need a rectangle here in the center. We'll make a rectangle, select both, subtract. We need this, and we need this one and this one together. Combine it. We need this one together, we need this one together, we need this, and here we don't need this. So we'll take a rectangle from here, select both of them, subtract. After that we don't need this portion, so I'll duplicate a ring here, keep it over it. We'll select both of them, we'll go to shape builder, and this separate this one, separate this one, and here we'll delete this portion, or delete this portion. Now you got the cool nice ending of the object. Now let's fill it with some colors. So let's fill it with some gradient color. We'll choose green color here, light green and dark green, maybe this one little bit of yellowness, and this one greenness. We will make it linear, and with the gradient tool just fill it with the color. fill this color with maybe brown color. Fill this color maybe with the same color brown. We will fill this color with some gradient color, maybe orange. Fill it with orange color. And in the here you will increase the intensity and just apply the gradient here. After you have applied the gradient, we will apply the same gradient to this portions too. We combine this using the Pathfinder tool and we'll apply the same gradient here. Just click and maintain the flow of the gradient. This one, let's fill it with some black color. Put your text somewhere here. And this is how you can make a unique design or professional logo, and you can even adjust the text if you have some kind of word you want to put here. So this is how you can make a unique and a professional logo. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Thank you.